Michael, why Ontario?
Ontario is the economic engine of Canada. 35% of the population of Canada lives in Ontario, as well as 40% of the GDP is generated in Ontario, and 50% of all manufacturing jobs in Canada are located in Ontario. So not only are we headquartered in Ontario, but also our target market is in Ontario because of all those economic factors.
What's so interesting about investing into apartment buildings?
Apartment buildings, according to the banks, are the safest forms of investment within the real estate industry. Whereas with commercial properties, you may lose a tenant and end up with an empty building. People always seem to be willing to pay for a roof over their heads, whether economic times are good or economic times are bad.
Where does your profit come from?
Our profit comes from rental of apartments. Obviously, we have a margin that's being generated above and beyond what our expenses are. The rents that are paid are much higher than what our expenses, including our mortgage debt expenses, are. And obviously, we then redeploy those profits back into the business.
How do you pick your apartments?
We have a very, very focused target. We focus on apartment buildings that are located usually in Ontario's secondary communities. We do have some of our portfolio located in Toronto, but most of the buildings are located in London, Niagara Falls, Hamilton, Ottawa, and Kingston. And we concentrate on properties that are between 25 and 100 units. They're the smaller buildings, they're not the large towers. These are buildings most of the time without elevators or without underground parking, which are the greatest expense and maintenance items. So it makes us much more profitable than, for example, the owners of large apartment towers would be.
Are there many companies like yours that gather apartment buildings and that kind of property in Ontario?
We are currently the only pure apartment play that is not a real estate investment trust within Ontario that are consolidating a very fragmented market. It is a market that has over 200,000 apartment units just within our small focus sphere that we target for acquisition. As a matter of fact, we have over the past 16 months grown by 400% within this particular marketplace.
How expensive is it to finance the apartments you purchase?
Apartments are a very, very attractive form of investment for the banks. Not only that, but Canada Mortgage and Housing Corporation, which is a government-sponsored agency, insures mortgages on residential buildings. As a consequence, we have the opportunity to borrow long-term at the lowest cost. For example, our borrowing interest rates currently are in the range of approximately 4.5% for a 10-year term on a 25-year amortization, which is historically at a low point for mortgage rates, number one. Number two, it obviously adds to our profits because whereas we purchase buildings at an 8.5% cap rate, we borrow at 4.5%. That gives us a 400 basis point positive investing spread for our apartment buildings.
How about the quality of the apartments and the buildings? Don't tenants simply use it up and the quality depreciates during time?
There is no question that apartment buildings do suffer some depreciation. We have a very proactive repair and maintenance program that addresses problems before they occur, so we don't run into major repair, renovation, or upgrade items. We continually strive to manage our buildings in such a manner that the tenants are happy, and when you have a happy tenant, he keeps a good house.
On the long run, will tenants in Ontario be able to pay the same rent or even higher rent than they're able to pay now?
There's obviously going to be some effect of inflation that creeps into it. I would say that rents have remained fairly static in Ontario over the past number of years and will probably increase marginally in the coming years. We obviously strive to provide the best accommodation for value to our tenants within Ontario. But having said that, obviously there are some unavoidable costs, such as utility and tax, realty tax expenses, that will have to be passed on to the tenants.
What kind of apartment buildings do you go after?
We go after buildings usually that have been well maintained but badly managed. They usually have below market rents, which gives us an opportunity to bring our professional management style to the building and raise rents over a period of time. Most of the buildings that we own are targeted to blue-collar and lower-level white-collar workers that have a tendency to be longer-term tenants than young professionals who usually are much more mobile and have a tendency to acquire a house after a number of years of renting.
How do you manage your buildings and apartments better than other owners?
Most of the apartment buildings that we purchase have previously been owned by people that have maybe one or two apartment buildings that do this as a hobby or do this as a retirement plan, not professionally. We bring professional management to the buildings. For example, in most cases where we buy a building, it would have been owned by a wife and husband, where the husband would be at work, the wife would clean the apartment buildings during the day, and the husband would do the plumbing or electrical repairs when he got home in the evening when he could get to it. We have a professional team of plumbers, electricians, flooring specialists, and we have a 24-hour service line that people can call at any time to bring out our professional repair and maintenance people. This is very, very advantageous to the tenants, and this is one of the reasons why we have tenants that stay a long time within our apartment buildings.
What good or bad surprises in that market should you be prepared for?
I guess the major surprise that we had, and it's one that has affected populations around the world, of course, is the rising energy prices. So what we have done in order to counter that is we have started installing energy-efficient boilers, for example, in our heating systems. Where we needed, we have replaced windows to cut down on air getting into or out of the apartments in order to make it more energy efficient. And obviously, in this manner, we're going to try to limit the impact of energy price increases on our company.
How do you try to make your company more interesting to the investor than any other company who does the same thing?
Very easy. Number one, we continue to be very focused on apartment buildings. We continue to focus geographically. We continue to focus on the size of buildings that we buy. We continue to purchase apartment buildings that are in close proximity to other apartment buildings that we already own, therefore lowering the cost of management, as well as we have exhibited growth that no other apartment owner of our size or within our industry has. As I mentioned before, we have grown over 400% in the last 16 months. We have gone from less than 250 apartment units to over 1,100 apartment buildings within that period of time. And of course, we expect to continue that growth. We have, in the last less than 12 months, raised over $13.5 million in both equity and convertible debt in order to finance our growth and our expansion plans.
What qualifies you personally for the business you're in?
I feel that I'm an individual that has had long business experience, and at the end of the day, to manage an apartment building or to manage a portfolio of apartment buildings really takes, I believe, a lot of common sense and a lot of business experience. Because at the end of the day, what you have to generate is a profit for your shareholders. I am the largest shareholder within the company. I personally own approximately 28% of the issued shares in the company, so it's very much to my benefit to make sure that this company grows and prospers.
What do you love about your business?
Every day is a different challenge. Every building is a different challenge. It makes me feel good that, number one, I'm providing a good value to families within our apartment buildings. I enjoy the challenge of negotiating the best possible deal that I can for the company, which of course makes sense from the perspective that really, as is always standard in real estate, you make money buying, not selling real estate. And I certainly enjoy the challenges that are created on managing the business on a daily basis.
What do you think is the real profit potential in your business?
In my business, what is the best that a lot of people really, really miss out on is that when we go out and we buy a building, we purchase a building with 25% cash down from the company, and 75% of it we mortgage with a bank. What happens is that as our tenants pay their rents to us on a monthly basis, we continue to pay that mortgage down. So at the end of the mortgage term, we own an asset. We own a building that is there. It's going to be there tomorrow. That's going to be there 10 years from now. That's probably going to be there 100 years from now. And after the mortgage term is completed, we own that building free and clear. We collect the cash flow from it. But over that period of years, we didn't really pay for it. It was our tenants paying their rents that paid for that asset. There is no other business on earth where that can happen, where you own an asset that somebody else has paid for. And that's the beauty of the real estate business. And that's what I offer to the investors who are investors in IntraRent, that basically they are really only borrowing the money from our tenants that they're investing in IntraRent.
Tell me more about your growth strategy.
We expect our growth that we exhibited in the past 16 months of 400% to continue by taking a very, very fragmented market within Ontario and consolidating that market going forward. There's a tremendous opportunity to grow this business because there are a number of vendors of properties that are coming to the age where they would like to sell their buildings. They've owned the buildings for a period of time. So what we're looking to do is to consolidate this industry and be the only consolidator of mid-sized buildings in mid-sized Ontario communities to grow it into a very, very significant ownership position. We believe that by acquiring only 6% of this market within Ontario, we will still become a $500 million company over the next short period of time.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you very much, Gorg. It was a pleasure being here.